Hi guys, and welcome back from Carly at the Herbothecary. Really good to see you guys again. If you're new to the channel or like the videos, please show your support by hitting like and subscribe down below. This is the second of our Christmas crochet videos. In the first one, we did the simple 3-round snowflake. In this one, we will be doing a 4-round snowflake. For this, you'll need to know how to slip stitch, single crochet, and double crochet. Now, I'm using a very thin embroidery yarn for this, so I dropped my hook down to 2.75 millimeter. However, if you're using a thicker yarn, please use the hook that's advised with the yarn. So with all our projects, we start with a slip stitch, and then we're going to chain 5. So that's yarn over, pull the yarn through the loop on your hook, and repeat this 5 times. We're then going to slip stitch to that first chain, so in through the chain, yarn over at the back, and pull through everything. We will be working in double crochets in this round, in through the circle. So we will chain 3, which counts as our first double crochet. Now I'm working around my tail as well, as it makes it easier to pull tight at the end. We're then going to do another double crochet, so yarn over, in through the middle of that loop, remembering to tuck in your tail, yarn over, pull through, 3 on the hook, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, and pull through those final 2. So now we have 2 double crochets. We're then going to do a 2 chain gap in between these. So we're going to chain 1 and 2 and do another 2 double crochets. So yarn over, in through the loop, yarn over at the back, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over and pull through 2. We'll then do this again, yarn over, into the loop, yarn over, pull through, 3 on the hook, see, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over and pull through 2, and we have 2 double crochet clusters. We're going to chain 2 and repeat this process until you have 6 of those 2 double crochet clusters with a chain 2 gap in between. So this is our final double crochet. We're now going to chain 2. We have 6 clusters, so chain 2, and we're now going to slip stitch to that 3rd chain on the chain 3 that we did, that counted as our first double crochet. So in through the front, yarn over, and pull through everything. And that is the end of round 1. In round 2, we will be working in double crochets again, and we will be working into the gaps in between the clusters. So we will chain 3, then into that first gap, we'll do 2 double crochets. So yarn over, in through that first gap, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over and pull through 2. We'll then repeat this again. Another double crochet. We're then going to chain 2 in between, and into that very same gap do another 2 double crochets. We are then going to repeat this 2 double crochet and chain 2 double crochets in each of those chain 2 spaces. So without chaining, you go directly into the next chain 2 gap with 2 double crochets, chain 2 double crochets, until we get to that very last chain 2 space. Now we have 5 of those 2 double crochets, chain 2, 5 double crochet clusters, and we're now on that last chain 2 space from the previous round. We do, however, have that chain 3 that we did. So what we're going to do now is do 2 double crochets into this gap. We're then going to chain 2. And this time all we need is 1 double crochet, as that chain 3 is going to act as the second one. So we'll do 1 double crochet here, and then we are going to slip stitch into that 3rd chain of the chain 3 that we did, and this will complete round 2. In round 3, we'll be creating the points of our snowflake. So this will be a series of slip stitches, chains and double crochets. So we're going to chain 3, Then in the gap between those, that two double crochet cluster, we're going to do three double crochets in here. So that's one, two, and three double crochets. We're then going to chain three again, and in the gap between those clusters, we're going to do a slip stitch. So that's into the gap in between the double crochet clusters, and we're just going to yarn over and pull through everything. And we're going to repeat this in between each of those two double crochet, chain two double crochet clusters. So we'll chain three again into that next gap. We'll do three double crochets. We'll then chain three again, slip stitch in between those clusters, chain three, and repeat this process again. So in between each of those two double crochet, chain two double crochet clusters, we now have three double crochets and a chain and a slip stitch in between each of those clusters, and this should give us 6 points. I'll meet you guys back at the end. So now we've completed our third triple double crochet cluster. We're going to chain three again, and now we want to slip stitch to the base of where we did that first chain three section. So I like to go underneath it in order to get a nice grip. So underneath the base of that chain three, yarn over, pull through everything to complete round three of our four round snowflake. In our fourth and final round, we will be working around those chain threes and into those three clusters. So we're going to do one single crochet, two single crochets, and a third single crochet around that chain three. We now come to our three double crochet cluster, and we are going to go into that loop at the top of the first one. If you see it is on the right, you might have to move your single crochets. So in that, we are going to do a slip stitch. We're then going to chain three to do the first of our little hookies at the side. We're then going to go into the second double crochet and do a slip stitch again. We're then going to chain four, and back into that second double crochet, we're going to do another slip stitch. We'll then chain three and slip stitch into that third double crochet, and then to balance it out, three more single crochets around that next chain three. This now brings us to the slip stitch from the previous round. So to secure that, I like to go through this slip stitch with another slip stitch, and now we're going to repeat this on the next one. So three single crochets around the chain three, then slip stitch into the first of the double crochets, chain three, slip stitch into the second of the double crochets, chain four, slip stitch back into that double crochet, chain three, slip stitch into the third double crochet, then three single crochets around the chain three, and slip stitch into the previous round slip stitch. Repeat this around all six of your arcs, and I shall meet you back at the end. So we're at our sixth and final point of our snowflake. Now at this point, you can just slip stitch down to the base of that first single crochet that you did, snip your yarn and finish it off if you wish to use it as an embellishment like on these hats. However, if you do want to hang it from a tree or any other hanging, you can then chain 10 and slip stitch back down to that base to make a little hanger for it. At this point, snip your yarn, pull it through, and darn in all your loose ends. And that's the second version of our crochet Christmas snowflake completed. Now, as no two snowflakes are the same, I do like to have a few different versions, so I will be doing a video on at least a third one, maybe even a fourth. But for now, I'm very happy with that. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please come back again soon, as we will have many, many more. And don't forget to hit like and subscribe if you did like the video. Please feel free to comment below, send any pictures if you've made your own. You can follow us at The Hook and Knot Nook on Facebook, and we will soon be adding Instagram and Twitter, and I will put the links to those in the comments below.